Good evening, everyone. This is Nimish, your host, founder and director of Career Naksha. Today we have our 35th guest, Prinkit Patel, who will be joining us in a couple of minutes, and he will be talking about how he has built his career in digital marketing space and also some of his initiatives that he has started quite a bit time now. He is a digital marketer. Like I said, he is also an entrepreneur, and he started his own digital media firm, Prinkit.in, and also he has his own Change Vadodara media page, and he has been doing digital marketing since many years now, and always looking to share knowledge with youths. So we will be interacting with him today. Feel free to ask questions, how to build career, what are the opportunities in this space, and also how digital marketing is taking over the online mode with COVID-19 situation. So feel free to ask questions live and interact with him while we are going live in a few minutes.
Yeah, so I'm also very excited for the same, and I consider it as a responsibility being, you know, a part of industry, that we all, you know, we should share what this industry is, how this is going, so that more and more people, more and more students can know how to become a part of it.
Great.
Thank you so much for inviting.
Yeah, welcome, Prinkit. Both of us are live now. Thank you so much for joining in, and once again, welcome on our show of Sai Guidance Ghar Se. Basically, we have started this almost 45 days back, and we have been bringing experts from diverse fields. So once again, thank you for joining in and talking about digital marketing. So let's start with, tell us about your career journey so far. How did you come into this space? How did you start your initiatives? And then we will take up more questions as we go.
Amazing. A very nice question. So, you know, since my childhood, I was very curious about a lot of things. How this happens, how that happens. So, and then I did 12th. After that, I, you know, took mechanical engineering as my for bachelor's. And while doing mechanical engineering, I did a lot of things. So Change Vadodara campaign is an NGO that I started when I was in 12th. And it grew from around, you know, from one member to around a team of 1,700. With the help of social media. We did a lot of online, you know, social media engagement and influence. With the help of influencers, we grew it. After that, while I was in mechanical, now, because, you know, we did not have something like Career Naksha then, I had to choose my career based on instincts. So I thought, let me do mechanical, I love machines. I went in there and I realized this is whole, you know, a different world. Here, I thought I'll be learning about machines, but then I had to know fluidity and the equations. So then I lost my interest. And that is when I started a few more businesses. I started, and all of them, you know, became successful with the help of digital platforms. So then I realized, instead of focusing on any specific business, I just for information, I started a badge making business. And then it also grew with the help of Instagram. So then I realized that, you know, my major inclination, any business I start, is towards digital. With the help of digital resources, I can grow it. So at that moment, I realized that, you know, digital marketing is something that I should do. And, you know, a very interesting thing happened when I was in third year and during my exam. So at the night of last paper, I realized, what am I doing? And then I thought, I should be into digital marketing. So, you know, exams are kind of self-realization period when you cannot do anything else and sit with books and you realize a lot of things in life. So I thought digital marketing is something I should do, and then I made a website on the same night, and then from then till now I'm doing this, digital marketing. So this is how I came into this. And Prinkit.in as an organization has grew very fast. So it's been less than 2 years, and we have a team, you know, of people. We have a lot of clients, and we are at a level where, you know, we can compete with the industry in our city and our state.
Great. Ankit, you told about your career journey. So tell us more about brands. So you said you work with digital brands, you are building some digital brands, you are helping them with digital marketing. So let's start that conversation about what digital marketing is and how you are helping these brands build a digital platform or digital content for them.
Amazing. So like, see, every organization, every brand has their own goals. MSU, you know, as we are talking, Karan Akshay is also a startup from MSU. So MSU is one of our clients. So like, you know, every organization has their own set of goals. For MSU, it is, you know, changing public perception. For any real estate business, it is, you know, selling their houses and building trust in probable buyers. For a beauty salon, it can be footfall. You know, for any other educational institute, it can be generating, you know, more and more walk-ins and admissions. So every organization has a goal. And so like, who has goal? Let us say every organization has a product or service to share. MSU is, you know, sharing their entire curriculum of learning. A salon is, you know, sharing services. So you need a way to communicate with the probable consumer, right? So if I have a course to sell, there is somewhere a student in this world and I need to communicate with him or her so that I can tell him or her that yes, this is this course and you this can be beneficial for you. So between, you know, organization and its product and a probable consumer, we act as a bridge. So now this bridge is there since long, but it has transformed from, you know, conventional, from offline to digital.
Right.
Like earlier, if someone had to, I would say, let us say a real estate industry, earlier if there is a builder or there is a saloon and they, let us say there is a builder and they want to sell their houses. So earlier they used to go to, you know, offline mediums like holding campaign or newspaper ads and, you know, billboard ads, those, you know, three-wheel cycles with backlight running in city. So this is what they were doing till now. But then, now that, you know, a lot of people are, you know, online, and after this geo revolution, major part of our country, in fact, world is, you know, at the, you know, just on their screens. So we can find them on the screens. So now all these businesses are, you know, converting from conventional to digital. So that is what we exactly do. We understand businesses, what they do, who their probable customer is. And then we find them on digital platforms. If someone is buying a property, then he must be searching on Google, okay, what he needs to do before buying a property, which properties are good in my city, what should I consider before buying a property. You know, they must be looking on social media. So everywhere the probable customer is on digital platforms, we reach there and pass on the message that our brand or the, you know, client we serve for has to give. So that is what we do in a nutshell.
Great. So, also tell us about something like some of the challenges and how you are solving those challenges in the current situation. Like helping the brands, like you said, like adopt certain digital platforms, like you said, social media, having online campaigns, utilizing Google. So if you can tell, what are the challenges for these brands who have been conventional and now how are they adopting and how are you helping those brands to come on these platforms?
Amazing question. So one bigger challenge is, you know, a lot of businesses in our city, in our state, in our country do not know what exactly digital is.
Right.
So this is the biggest challenge. You know, they are having a problem, but they do not know what the solution exactly is. And on the other hand, there are a lot of agencies, a lot of freelancers, even they do not know what exactly digital marketing is. So what happens is a person who has less knowledge of what digital marketing is hires an agency who has less knowledge. And then they collaborate and then they do something which brings no result. And what happens is at the end, agency stops by being shut and businesses loses their trust in digital. So this is what is happening currently. So every business I approach, for them, digital marketing is uploading 15 posters a month on social media. So like what I tell them is I do it for free. this is not digital marketing. This is just 1 or 2% of what digital marketing is. So this is the biggest challenge in our city and state, that they do not know what digital marketing is. So how we are solving is, earlier we thought of not solving it and finding people who actually know what digital marketing is. But then we thought that this is not going to work, because to help businesses, we need to help them understand what they need. So then we started with some initiatives, like we have started a Prinkit.in podcast. So with the help of these podcast series, businessmen will be able, they can just subscribe us, and then they'll get to know okay, what exactly digital marketing is. The sole purpose, we do not sell anything over there. We share content and help them understand okay, what digital marketing exactly is. So this is one thing that we are doing. We also have started a series of newsletters, offline newsletters, you know, hard copy newsletters, and we give it to free. Whoever wants it, any business, we give it to him or her for free every month. And it includes, you know, no promotion, but only content. Ki how, you know, exactly you can, what is digital marketing, what exactly you can do with it and such. So this was one challenge, and this is how we are trying to solve it. Another big challenge is, you know, I often say to a lot of people that, you know, in Alkapuri, you go on a terrace of any building and then you throw a stone. Wherever the stone falls on any you know, rooftop, probably there will be a social media company over there as well. So this is how dense the market is, right? Every person feels that I'm a social media manager. Every person says I'm a digital marketer. But the challenge is, you know, it needs to be deep. So when, you know, we go and meet any client, so, you know, he or she must have already taken any similar surveys, and they're very skeptical about this. You know, this digital does not bring money. It is just for branding, this and that. So changing that perspective is very, you know, was very important and was very challenging. Because when you want to do actual marketing, the prices will surely be high, because you have to hire, you know, valuable minds. So, you know, they feel that you have to do it, then what is different in you? So then you have to explain to them what digital is, what we do, and then we solve the problem. So this was a big challenge. And we solved this problem by building a special system called pilot project, Prinkit.in pilot projects, wherein, you know, any business wants to start digital marketing, we first do a pilot project for them. And then they see actual figures. They see some profit after spending everything, and then they increase budget, and then they keep on escalating their budget. So this is how we solve our second problem.
Great, Prinkit. So Prinkit, today we also have young professionals, graduates, right, students who are in college, and they have been thinking of building career in digital marketing. Right. And okay. It, like you said, it has become a trend recently, but in nutshell, the problem is people don't know it comprehensively to a deeper extent, like you said, right? Upar se sabko pata hota hai ki haan, social media chala lena, account chala lena, ya keywords analyze kar lena chota chota. But the overarching, the comprehensive deepness is not there. So can you tell our students, how can they acquire such skills, and what are these skills which can help them become a good digital marketing professional?
Mm-hmm. So, like, let us say after 10th you started. So there are three options: science, commerce, and arts. So if you know you can choose any field and go in digital. I'll tell you how. If you are taking science, then you can. If you are already focused about digital marketing, then you can, you know, prefer computer engineering, wherein, you know, you can, you know, learn a bit of coding, so that after you graduate, you can merge these skills with digital marketing. And you can also, if you, you know, have some knowledge of coding, then you can also use data science for digital marketing, which is a very emerging field and has a lot of career opportunities. And you can also, you know, machine learning and artificial intelligence are also trending these days in digital marketing. So I'll give you an example. You know, if you do random digital marketing, let us say there is a hair salon, A1 hair salon, I'll just give a random example. So if you do normal digital marketing, you will just be able to make creatives and boost posters for them. But if you know what data science is, what can you do is you can take data of their past 6 months of their clientele, you can make a RFM model, and then you can actually identify that who are probable, what is probable churn. That means ke on within, you know, few months, who is going to stop coming to our salon. You can predict that with the help of machine, and you can show ads specifically to them with some offers or something. So now this can be done with the help of, you know, combination of digital marketing and machine learning. So if you are taking science, you can do this. If you are taking commerce, then you can, you know, in digit, you can also specialize in financial analysis, break-even analysis, you know, budgeting and everything. And then you can learn, add it to the digital marketing skills. And if you are doing arts, then you can learn graphics designing, you can learn content creation and copywriting, and then merge it with digital marketing. So like, from science, you learn computer engineering. From commerce, you learn financial analysis. From arts, you learn this graphics and copy. But how will you learn digital marketing? So to learn digital marketing, see, there are a lot of institutes available in our city. But, you know, we have personally been to all of those institutes and also did campus placements. But the challenge is, you know, we are unable to find the, you know, talent over from there as well. Because, you know, I don't think such curriculum is enough to become a digital marketer to handle, you know, budget of lakhs of rupees. So for that, what I suggest is, and how I did it is, there are a lot of online courses available. And Google also has a course named Digital Unlocked, which can be your first, you know, course to start knowing what digital marketing is, which is completely free. You also get a certificate at the end of it. Facebook also has a lot of courses, which all are free. And these are actual content, because, you know, at the end, you are going to run ads on Google only, you are going to run ads on Facebook only, then why not to learn from them only?
Right.
Right. So, instead of going to any agency or, you know, institute, you directly learn from them, because they also keep on updating what, you know, they have. That is the best way to, you know, learn digital marketing and combine it with any science, commerce or arts thing.
Great.
Basic things that are needed are, so, you know, when we talk about science, commerce and arts, everyone, you know, who chooses any one of these can become a digital marketer. There are a lot of scope in it. Specifically, you know, a person must have analytical, you know, knowledge, analytical approach towards things. Let us say he comes to a situation. Let us say, aaj jammu ke nahi, aaj khana khao ke nahi. So, you know, instead of going on instincts and mood, he should have an analytical approach towards deciding this. Next jammanu kare marse, and then he decides, let me have my food. So that is, this mental approach should be there. If this is there, then only then, you know, he can survive in this industry. Along with that, this field is constantly growing. Even by me, you know, talking with you since 15 minutes, I am missing something, you know, because something has come in this industry that is new to me, right? So every day there has to be learning. You cannot say, I'll learn for 10 years and then for rest 30, 40 years, I'll strive in a corporate world. So that is, you need to learn daily. If you have learning attitude, then only then you will be a part of this industry, else you will go outdated very soon.
Great.
So these are few things which I feel are important.
Great. So Prinkit, I think you listed three important things. One, any student who wants to do digital marketing, either a science, commerce or arts, can go into digital marketing. That's one important suggestion. Second, if you are in this field, you need to be constantly reading, constantly up to date with the information that is available and how the digital marketing field is evolving, right? And third, very important point you said is, like, you need to go deeper. You can explore free courses online on Google, right, which are providing already digital certification, and Facebook, which are going to be the go-to platform for students every day, right? So I think that's a very important suggestion, Prinkit. Thanks for sharing that information. So today we also have young students who are in school, right, who are watching us closely. Everybody is sitting at home, right, because of COVID-19 situation. So any message for them, how they can utilize their time, anything specific you would like to say? Many of these students are already on social media platform, or they are a kind of small influencer also among their friends or in their environment, right? So can you just elaborate how they can utilize their time and give some tips around how they can capitalize on their own social media platforms they have been using?
Okay. So talking about, you know, utilizing time in this lockdown, I would like to give a general answer to this. See, when this lockdown thing happened, in the beginning few days, I was like, okay, this too shall pass. But then when I realized that this is going to be long, I sat one day, I dedicated my one day, full day, in deciding what am I going to do this in lock, what am I going to do in lockdown? Because this is, you know, I would say in decades, you get one such opportunity wherein the whole world is shut, right? This can be considered as a negative thing, but when we see the positives, there are a lot of them. So how I did it is, I feel that, you know, every individual needs to have balance between four B's. That is body, being, balance, and business. So if you have all these four in equal, you can be a happy person, you can progress in your career, you can do anything. So I utilize this lockdown to establish a strong balance in all this. So I'll tell you in detail, what is body, being, balance, and business? So body means your physical health. So, you know, you are home, you cannot go outside and eat pani puri, kachori and everything. So this is a good time wherein, you know, you can focus on your diet. You can eat things that are needed. Like if you have, you know, a very detailed answer, if you have less vitamin D, you can go in sunlight. No one is going to stop you. Your boss is not going to say no. And everything. So body and exercise, both are important. Being means meditation. A lot of people these days, young students, cannot meditate. I find, you know, it is very essential for any, you know, for anyone who is doing job, who is having business. Meditation connects you with your purpose. When you meditate, it gives you clarity of what is your roadmap ahead. So, you know, being means meditation. You can start meditating. At least you can start with 10 minutes and then try to extend it for 30 minutes. Balance. The third B is balance. So for balance means relationships. You need to have balance in your relationships. So you should spend time with your dad if you are not doing. You should spend time with your mom if you are not doing. You should spend time with your friends. If any of your friend has gone abroad, I personally have made a schedule that every Saturday evening around 10, I call two of my friends who are abroad and I talk at least for 1 hour with them. I have a schedule in advance. Ke bhai, phone karwana hai. So, you know, a lot of people who are not in my touch, this lockdown is helping me to, you know, be in their touch. And indirectly, they are sharing things which also make me grow. So balance, you know, in friends, in bosses and subordinates also balance is important. And at last, fourth B is business. Business or whatever gives money to your life or organization. So for that, for students, you need to start reading, you know, if you can do online courses. I also did 3-4 courses on Udemy and I also learned a lot of things. These days I am into, you know, learning Python and how to use it for Raspberry Pi. So I was afraid of coding, but this lockdown has helped me do that. So I feel very energetic when I learn something new. So for business, you know, these days for self-development, you do certificate courses, you can do, you read, start reading online books. You can, you know, you can also do SWOT analysis. If you are a working professional, you can do SWOT analysis of your business. And what are the strengths, opportunities, weaknesses, and then you can plan your, you know, roadmap ahead. So this is what we should do everything. Every day in lockdown should have these four B's included, and there has to be a strong balance. You know, when we get out of this lockdown with these four B's balance, you know, we'll grow exponentially.
Wonderful, really lovely message. Great, Prinkit, on sharing those four B's with all our viewers and also students. I think they will take this as a positive message, and I think it's going to help in everybody's life. Great, Prinkit. So last, we just got 12th Science Gujarat Board results yesterday. So, wanted to share that with you, and congratulations to all our viewers who are watching and have been coming to us for career guidance. So what, any message for those students who have given their board exams and they are coming to think about what career they can choose, how they should keep themselves motivated and also choose the right career path? Any suggestions around that, Prinkit?
So just want to say that journey, you know, of career is very exciting. It is like a roller coaster full of ups and downs. So those who are not satisfied with their results, that is completely fine. Not all people, you know, in fact, most of the people are not satisfied with their results. So don't worry if, you know, you have not you have not scored what you were expecting, and whatever you have scored. What I suggest is, you know, like career, there is a saying that in God we trust, all other must bring data. So, you know, we trust only in God. If you want to, you know, decide anything else, tell anything else, bring data. So, you know, this is a time when you can explore what your skills are, you know, the way Karan Akshar does it with a psychographic approach, you know, technical, scientific approach. So you all must explore what exactly your qualities are. See, I did mechanical engineering after 12 and then now I shifted to digital. So I choose a wrong career if I say, you know, those 4 years in mechanical, of course, I learned a lot of things, but then I came into digital. So, you know, I could not get the perfect career. Maybe I did not make the perfect decision. If I would have chose computer or something else, that would have been the best thing for me to do. So, you know, it is not necessary that you know what your answer is. This is a journey. You have to explore a lot of options. You have to, you know, do things. You realize that you are doing something which is not good, you shift to another. So that is completely fine to all those who are watching. But I would say, you know, focus on what your qualities are and then find a perfect career option for this. Don't go on which industry has more demand. If you do that and you try to fit in that industry, that is not the correct approach. Okay. And a lot of people do that and fail.
Right, Pinkesh. Yeah. I think you have clearly stated one important suggestion, right? The early you decide, the more better decision you make, you can accelerate your career, right? And also, like you said, it's a journey. You need to take chances. You also need to understand that there are options available. You need to explore. You need to take on that journey and keep on exploring, right? So very important. Great message to all our viewers as well. So I'll take one or two questions we have today, Prinkit. So there is one question around, like, how can students in this COVID-19 situation, I think you did touch upon that, can shape up their career in digital marketing? So I think you already answered, but if you can really elaborate on that, I think that will help.
Definitely. So this is a wonderful situation. I would say one course to you, that is a course by Google. The name is Digital Unlocked. So this is a very aggressive course. It gives you all knowledge that you need to actually get into this industry. In fact, I would say I did this only one course and then thought of starting this company. So this is that effective. And of course, it is not enough to become a digital marketer, but it is a good beginning. This is completely free. By the time you end it, you will also get a certificate from Google, which you can also use it in your resumes. So it is a perfect course to invest your time in. Once you are done with this course, the next step is, I think, you should start looking for an internship. So along with your education, you can look for a work from home internship, or maybe you can, you know, apply to plant, make a list of companies that you want to approach. Along with your studies, you can also do a part-time internship at any organization to get an inside view of what the organization looks like. And we are also open for internships. Anyone who is willing can definitely connect you, and then you can get in our touch. So I think this is what they can do.
Great, Prinkit. I think we are at the brink of our hour, and there were so many insights from your side, lot of information around building career in digital marketing, and also you stated a lot of prospects and opportunities for all our viewers. Great. Thank you for sharing that information. Thank you for elaborating on this career journey of yours, and also how you're building the company and how you are helping the brands. Hopefully many of our students who are watching today will definitely contact you, and also many other brands or companies who would contact you in terms of getting digitally more savvy and be able to come on such platforms and take help in this COVID-19 situation. So great. It was wonderful hosting you. Thank you so much, Prinkit. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much. Pleasure in all mine. Thank you. See you.
Great.